Hello and welcome to All About Sport. I'm Louise O'Reilly. I am here in Cavan Boxing Club where I'll be catching up with boxing sensation Kira Smith and some of the up and coming boxers from Cavan Boxing Club. I'm delighted to be speaking to Brian McKeown, chief coach here at Cavan Boxing Club. Brian, thank you very much for welcoming us into the club here this evening. They're all busy training here behind you, but tell us a little bit about what's going on here.
Well, actually, you're welcome to our latest new club. We're like a lot of the boxers in here, we're travellers. We've moved from place to place. But we're very, very happy here, and hopefully in the next week or two, they'll start work on the changing rooms, the showering facilities and things. We got a nice grant from the Sports Council and the AABA, and it'll be put to good use. But here tonight, we're just getting ready for the new season. We're just back from Kansas, as you know, the ringsides, and Kira's been at the European Games, and a few different lads have been boxing competitions over the summer. But we're just going through the warm-up session here behind us before we start tonight's training session. And really, the club opens next week, and this place is a hive of activity there. We're all through the winter, you won't be able to swing a cat in here, and it's unbelievable. We just keep going, and we just keep producing the champions. And delighted with John Joe on Tuesday night, another good win in America, and delighted for him. He's had his own little demons to fight, and he's overcome them, and he's back where he should be in the ring and doing what he should be doing, and that's boxing and winning. And in the Cavan Club here, we're all very proud of him, as I am of all my boxers.
We're here to have a little chat with Kira later on, but tell us a little bit about her, I suppose, her quest to get to Rio in 2016 for the Olympics.
Well, obviously, with the you know, outside of Katie here in Ireland, the female boxing program is, it's pretty limited, you know, particularly for the open class boxers, and we've had to travel to get our competition in that. As I say, we just come back again from the ringsides in America. We had a very good championship there. Kira come home with the elite open title, and Francis and Kaylee got to the final, and delighted with that. You know, Maria wasn't able to travel, as you can see. She's expecting shortly, and still training away. God knows how
remarkable,
she does it.
Isn't it, really?
It is remarkable. I don't know how the girl does it. She's an inspiration to everybody, and we'd have loved to have her this year. I'm sure she could have retained that title. But Kira's off now in 2 weeks to the Felixstowe Multinations in Warsaw. It's one of the top multinations in the world. All the top countries will be there, you know, the Mongolians, the Americans, the Brazilians, all the top female boxers will be there. So it's a good testing ground for her. And after the success she's enjoyed at the, particularly in Bulgaria earlier in the season and in the European Games, you know, she's boxing on top of her form. She's won 4 out of her last 5 international contests, which is very good by any standards. Eliminated by the eventual silver medalist at the European Games on a split decision, 2-1. One judge had her winning it. You know, it's all signs of progress, but we're building towards the World Championships in Kazakhstan. I think they're at the end of January, and that'll be the main qualifying tournament for the Rio Olympics. I think there's a small qualifying tournament in Europe, but the way the boxing is, even if you get to the quarterfinals in Kazakhstan, you still have to be in the top 3 in Europe, because geographically they select so many from each continent. So Europe's probably the strongest boxing nation now since the breakup of the old Soviet Union, and that you've so many of those little satellite countries now, and they're all producing the boxers, and it's getting more and more difficult to qualify for anything. Before, she has to negotiate her own senior championships in November, December, and that's our main priority at the minute. We're just going a good strength and conditioning program. She's come back after a horrible year out, and with injury and that, and she's boxing on top of her form, and I'm delighted with her form, and I know so are the high performance unit in Dublin, because since the surgery everything has improved, her running times, her strength and conditioning, you know, her actual physical body mass and everything. They're delighted with it, and they're the people that know, they're the professionals, they're the sports scientists and the whole lot, so we're all optimistic she'll do well, and she'll do us proud anyway, I'm sure of that.
Well, credit where credit's due, Brian. What is your secret to producing so many champions from Cavan Boxing Club?
I'm very, very lucky to be working with some of the best athletes in Cavan Town. There's no secret. The kids that put the work in are the kids that win. And a lot of these kids, they all have their own personal problems outside and that, and they're all trying to create an identity for them. It's a tough old time in the country in general, and you know, everybody wants to prove they're worth something, and if the work's not there and things like that, this gives an opportunity, and like at least in here they'll see the benefits of their work. We do our best to travel abroad. We go to international competitions all over Europe and America and everywhere else, and we bring as many as we can with us, you know, and that's the way we're bringing our lads through, by good competition, not by a dozen pushover jobs and a wink wink and away you go. We go for the difficult competition, we go for the hard competition, we go for the competition that develops us as boxers, and the develop as a boxer, they'll also develop as a person. You'll find very few of the boxers standing on street corners and beating kids up and things like that, you know. The boxers, when they finish here, they're tired, they go home and they go to bed.
Well said. Obviously, John Joe's moved on to professional ranks, but who here, you know, would you say, you know, we should be looking out for kind of some younger up-and-coming boxers?
Well, just behind me, there's young Francis Stokes there, who he actually amazed me in America. He won 3 fights and he lost to the American ranked number 2 in the final, again on a split decision. There's young Nathan over there, Nathan Mungan. He's been knocking on the door for years, you know. He just needs that little break, you know. It's always the Irish champion that eliminates him, and he just needs that little break, and once he overcomes that, I'm sure he'll do well. We have young Kayleigh there, that's it was her first trip away. She made it to the novice final, that's under 10 contests. Again, she's showing a lot of potential, and she's maturing as a person too, and toughening up. The wee girl's going out of her, and the young woman's taking over now. Obviously, Maria, if she gets over what she's expecting in December, I hope she'll come back here about 4 or 5 pounds heavier, and that'll make her eligible and, you know, heavy enough and strong enough for the latest weight division. And believe you me, the effort that she puts into it, she's quite capable of coming back with yet another Irish title. She's already won the intermediates. Couldn't go in the elite seniors last year because the minimum weight is 48 and she had to do 46. And listen, no matter what we put in her, we couldn't get her up to the minimum weight. So hopefully after the baby, it'll be a wee bit heavier, you know.
Which is great. Well, look at Brian, onwards and upwards, and best of luck with everything that is yet to come here at Cavan Boxing Club. Thank you very much.
Right, thanks for your time.
Thank you. Well, I'm delighted to be joined by Ciara Smith, boxing sensation here in Cavan Boxing Club. Ciara, thanks so much for taking the time out from that intensive training and speaking to us on All About Sport. It's great to be here with you. You were busy there in the background, you know, taking over from Brian.
I was. I led the warm-up. All the kids I've been away with over the past few weeks, and some of my sparring partners in there. Brian's just doing some school combat with them at the moment, so I'm going to sit out now to talk. So thanks for coming in today.
Oh, you're very welcome. Ciara, you've been a really busy lady over the last couple of years, but over the summer you have just come back from Kansas, from the Ringside World Club Championships, and that's the second time that you've won that particular competition.
Absolutely, it was a good tournament. Cavan Boxing Club travel out. I think there was a team of 12 all together, including Virginia Boxing Club, and I went out with 5. I actually went out with Kayleigh Smith here, Francis Stokes, Harrison Jemison from Virginia was there with us, and who else am I forgetting? Maria O'Rourke was out there last year, and Nathan Mongan there, he was in Denmark last year with us. So we had a strong team going out. Obviously, I'm delighted I won it out. It was my second time. Unfortunately, you know, some of our guys missed out to the American number of ones and twos and was unlucky, but it was a fantastic experience for me. It's my second time, as I said. The kids are a lot younger coming up, and I'm sure they'll go back and win many more titles. So,
here.
I do.
And I was just commenting on how heavy it is, because when you brought in to the studio the last time, 2 years ago, yeah, the other belt, I don't remember it being this heavy, so it
wasn't.
Fantastic. So where do you keep these all, in your room at home, or have you a little cabinet now?
I wish I had a cabinet. They kind of just stack up. Mom calls them dust catchers, but you know,
after all your
efforts. But no, it's fantastic. Like, I was happy with my performances out there, and after a long year, and Azerbaijan, Baku, it was good. It was my fifth time there, so I suppose for the kids, six rings going at once, it was a huge experience for them, whereas I've become quite accustomed to now. It's not as much of a wow factor. I'm just right, okay, let's get in here now and do the business. Chill out after.
Just before that, back in junior in Azerbaijan for the European Games, how did that go, Kira?
That was truly one of the most amazing competitions I've ever been to. It was kind of like, I suppose, a taster for what a huge Olympics would be like, because it was the first ever European Games and European Olympics. You had all the sports going at once, and it had a real wow factor for me. We were there for a month, and we had a training camp beforehand. We were kind of based in the city. And then after about 2 weeks, we went to the Olympic Village. And I should have brought in some of the pictures. They're just incredible. You know, you're kind of sitting having food, and you have like Olympic gold medalists from every sport just walking by you or sitting beside you eating. And the standard was just so impressive right across the board, from boxing to basketball, badminton, swimming, athletics. You know, it was just, it was breathtaking, and it was fantastic to be a part of it. And, you know, coming so close, I suppose, to a medal, it was kind of heartbreaking. But after the year I had, I kind of had to sit back and realise, okay, it wasn't a complete letdown, because I was told realistically I was very lucky to be there. It was the top 16 in Europe from my weight. And the girl who beat me on a split decision from Russia, she's actually European number two. And I boxed her last year in Germany, and she beat me well. So a split decision to European number two for a bronze medal. So close, but so far, you know.
And you were plagued. You had injuries last year, so you were really coming back.
I had a very, very bad year last year. I actually missed out on the World Championships in Jeju, Korea. I missed America last year with Brian, and I missed two other trips. But realistically, I wouldn't have been fit to compete, and I shouldn't have probably been in the Europeans in Romania last year. I went into hospital, and I had a few surgeries here and there. But, you know, I'm back bigger and stronger, and it's so good to be back, especially at elite level. And you know, Baku was a real eye-opener for me. It kind of made me hungrier this year.
You're obviously very busy with the high-performance team in Dublin. And give us an insight to how that goes, you know, from Monday to Friday, I presume, when you're up there.
Well, we had a week off after Baku, and I came back, and we actually travelled to England's High Performance and Sheffield, and we had a training camp there. And when I came back, I had America, and now on the 8th, I fly for Multinations, Felix Stam in Poland. So, like, from Monday to Friday, I suppose, it kind of goes in rotation. I have strength and conditioning Monday morning, and then boxing or sparring or technical work in the evening. And then Tuesday morning, it'll be a track session. It could be shuttle sprints, it could be long distance. All depends on the stage of competition. And then the evening time, it'll be same thing again, technical work, bag work, pads, sparring, school combat. So every day is kind of changes a bit.
Are you training with the likes of Katie Taylor and Paddy Barnes and different boxers like that?
I am indeed. Katie probably does most of her training at home, which is fine. She comes up closer to competition for sparring. Paddy and Michael, you know, they've qualified for Rio, so they're still training hard. I'm sure they want to go out and get a gold medal. You know, Paddy, two-time bronze medal. Everyone's that bit hungrier, and you can see getting closer now to nationals, closer to competitions. Everyone's just working very, very hard.
You have such a busy life. You're a student in DCU, so on top of being a student, coming home and training here with Brian, training with the high-performance team in Dublin, how do you fit everything in?
Well, this year I've actually deferred because I've wanted to give 110% to my boxing. I see how close I got in Baku, and I was kind of saying, right, if I hadn't got injuries or if I had done that extra training session instead of that double lecture, would it have made a difference? So this year I've decided just to put that aside and give it 110% for the boxing. But before that, for the last 2 years, it has been tough. I'm not going to lie. I've probably underachieved in college, even though I passed everything. It's just because you're kind of trying to balance everything, I suppose. So, you know, I'm going to give it 100% this year, and then when I do go back to study, give it 100% rather than my 75 like the last 2 years.
You literally missed out on the London Olympics by a very fine margin. But going forward, the qualifiers for the Olympics is coming up in the new year. How is your preparations coming about for that? And how are you feeling, I suppose, to compare your performances now to when you missed out for the London Olympics? Where do you think you're at?
For London Olympics, I always think back. Of course, I had an injury then too. I got cast, took up my arm 10 days beforehand. But in saying that, I got beat by an outstanding opponent, Karolina Michuk from Poland. She was world champion at 54 kilo. And it was funny because apart from Katie Taylor, she was the only other boxer I had followed for about 5 years. So when I heard the name, and I was like, oh crap, I'm getting into the ring with, you know. Oh. But, you know, a lot of things have changed since then. I've had a lot of fights against fantastic opponents, close fights. I mightn't have won them all, but, you know, like last year in Poland, the same competition, the Felix Sam, I'm travelling in 2 weeks, I boxed the Olympic bronze medalist, and she's the current world champion from USA, Marlene Esparza. And I had a really close fight with her. And I came out afterwards, I actually got sick and went to hospital, shouldn't have been boxing. I was like, God, that was a good girl. So since London, I've definitely had a lot more experience. I've boxed at least the top five in the world. You know, 2 weeks ago I was moving around the ring with Nicole Adams, and she's fast, she's a fantastic athlete, all right. But, you know, I'm not fazed the same way. If I met the Polish girl again, I'd say, right, let's go. One fight, it was a different fight last time, but...
So as much as being physically prepared, you're more mentally prepared?
Absolutely. I'm not as fazed by it anymore, and I'm doing it a lot longer. I think my age as well, I've gotten maturity stronger. The training aspect, I'm training at a better intensity, and I'm sparring, you know, the best in the world, Paddy Barnes, Brendan Irvine, and fantastic technical coaches. It's Brian McKeown, Billy Walsh, you know, I've got a great team behind me.
When you actually get into that ring here, you know, what does be going through your head, or, you know, what's it like?
When I'm in the ring, I'm 100%. When you're in the ring, it's fine. I think it's beforehand, it's probably more mind psyching out. You're sitting, you're getting your hands taped up and signed off, and your opponent's standing next to you, she's getting signed as well and taped up, and it's kind of the weight beforehand that is more in your mind. Once you're in the ring, you're fine. It's preparation sitting in the dressing room where you're kind of like, oh, here it goes. But I think the day I'm not nervous is the day I'll probably really underperform. Nerves is good.
Nerves, yeah, that's just what they say. You were saying you actually have to give credit to some of the guys here in the ring behind us who have done a lot of sparring with you over the years in preparation.
Absolutely. I can look at all these guys. There's two of my best sparring partners there, a little bit heavier than me now, but we still have a very good war, Francis Stokes and Harrison Jemison. They were both very unlucky in America. Francis got a late call up and he came out and he competed very well. He lost out on a split decision to the American number two. Harrison, he's from Virginia Boxing Club. He's a little bit heavier than me now, but we did kind of kill each other as well. Who else am I looking at?
You're not afraid when you go in to spar against them at all. You don't have this... Or are they afraid to kind of
say, you know, throw a punch?
You know, if they didn't know me, they probably would be. But I think the fact that I've grown up with all these kids, when I walked in here first, I was a little 15-year-old shy girl, and I've grown up with everybody here. You know, even Nathan's bigger than me now. He used to always spar. I still work a lot with him. And, like, I have to give as much credit, because this is where I started off and this is where I've learned, you know, all my foundation skills, and I still work with these guys. And you know, I have to look behind me to see who I'm missing out on. Oh, here's two fantastic opponents. Keely Smith, very unlucky out in America, one of the hardest trainers in here. And I have to say, she really kind of reminds me of myself, the way she trains. And in a few years, she'll definitely be one to watch out for. Maria O'Rourke, she's never out of the gym. She's
part legend, isn't she? Really?
Yeah. She may be small, but she definitely makes up for it in training and her fight and ambition.
Great. So coming up next for you, Kira, you've a lot of competitions ahead, so tell us about them.
On the 8th of September, I'm out in the Felix Stam in Warsaw in Poland. Easily the top 10 females in the world will be there, so it's going to be it's a ranked A multi-nation, so it's going to be a tough tournament for me. Hopefully I get some very good experience out there, win some fights, that's the plan as always. But my main focus now is my nationals, because I have to remain number one to go to Olympic qualifiers in January in Kazakhstan.
So it's all exciting. You really have a really big year ahead, and you're packing a lot in. I mean, you get to see a lot. You travel a lot with the boxing, which is a great part of it.
Absolutely. You know, no matter what I take away from boxing or the places I've been, my favourite part is probably the friends I've met from all over the world that I still keep in contact with. As you said, I have travelled a lot, without a doubt. Probably too much, but no, I wouldn't change it. I've enjoyed every second of my boxing, I'm hoping for a big year.
We are definitely going to be following you. We've been really following your journey, you know, over the last number of years. But we look forward to seeing what the future holds for you. So, Kira, thank you so much for taking time out from the ring and speaking to us on All About Sport. And very best of luck. Thank you. Thank you.
And then you go with your up you go. Come on, start.
Okay, so we're here in the ring, and I'm going to be speaking to some of the up-and-coming boxers that have a really great future ahead of them in boxing, and they've just finished a really tough training session. So, Brian, you're all very welcome. Thank you for speaking to us on All About Sports. Brian, tell us a little about some of the fights that we've had over the past few months.
We'll go left to right here anyway. The young girl on the far side, that's Kelly Schmidt. She's an Ulster champion. The only fight she's lost in Ireland's been to the Irish champion, and she come back from the ringside with a silver medal in the novice stage. Next one's young Eamon Mahon. Eamon has an Ulster championship this year and a Nine Counties title. Again, very, very unlucky. Didn't go all the way in the All-Irelands, but he has the potential to do it next year. Hiding in there's Maria. I know she's getting bigger every day. But Maria's an exceptional athlete in her own right. You know, she won the ringsides last year, and she's an Irish Intermediate champion and an Ulster Intermediate champion. And hopefully in the new season, she'll be back and be boxing again with us and be boxing well.
When you say bigger, we just have to point out that she's actually 6 months pregnant, Brian.
It amazes me. I'm not joking you.
Not bigger because of eating, but bigger because of...
You know, I used to blame myself for feeling bad in the morning. I don't know how she does it. I honestly don't, but so that's another story. The next one's Francis there. Francis A. Reichen is he's one that's destined for a lot of success. I'd be very, very confident of that. He's a good boxing brain, a good ability. He's just come back from Kansas with a silver medal in the open class. The open class 16-year-olds, and the lad that beat him actually come out of Laurie Holmes' gym in Atlanta, Georgia. So he was number two in America. So it shows you the progress he's made.
Is that one of your first fights or professional fights or, I suppose, big fights, should I say?
That was his first trip abroad, you know. Yeah. And he won three fights out there and got beat in the final. So they don't give these trophies away, you know. You have to win them out there. And in America, you have to fight. And he's done his proud out there anyway. Then we have Ronan. I don't know what to say about Ronan. Ronan's a bit of a playboy. The less I say, the better. But Ronan was eliminated from the championships this year by the Irish champion. And I think the only two people in the arena that day that thought he lost it were the two judges that called it against him. But that's the way it goes.
They're brothers, aren't they, Ronan and Patrick?
Yeah, Ronan and Francis are two brothers.
Francis, sorry.
Then we have Stephen McDonough here. Stephen's just in the club a few months. And progressing rightly, and he should do fine. He should do all right in the coming season. Behind you have Martin there. Martin won the ringsides last year. He won the novice 75 kilos, and wee bit of a funny year for him last year. He was in and out, and he just really didn't put it in. So it'll be interesting to see how he does this year. I have no doubt if he puts the effort into it, like he has the ability to achieve an awful lot more, but again, he needs to have that hunger himself. The next one's Horison Jameson there. Horison's from, he actually boxes out of Virginia, but he's a pupil here in Cavan, and he trains a lot with us in here in the gym, and talented boy. He was eliminated in Kansas at the semi-final stage by the eventual champion, and again, it was touch and go. The European style of boxing against the brawling style of the Americans, you know, unfortunately, on the day it went to the brawler, and although I thought he was a good winner, which unfortunately I wasn't judging. And then next you have Nathan. That's Nathan's one of the unsung heroes in the club, one of the hardest workers. He's been boxing since he was 10 years of age. His father actually boxed with me, and when you see him boxing, he's the picture of the father. Just like to see Nathan get a little bit nastier, and just that wee bit of a bite in him. He's knocking on the door. He's been there. He's been an Ulster champion. He's been a Nine County champion. He's won his titles and that. And he gets the break this year. He'll test the best of them. He'll test the best of them anyway. But when you look at most of the lads and lassies here, when you're looking at them, it's unbelievable that crew there, there's not one of them that wouldn't be in the top half dozen in Ireland at the minute in the ratings. Every one of them would make the top half dozen of the best boxers in Ireland at the minute, and I'm proud to be associated with them. And the people of Cavan can know that anywhere these boys go, they're a credit to their club and their county, and they're a credit to their families, and they'll not let anybody down.
Which is
is great. We'll have a few words with some of the boxers. So this is, I suppose, the future of Cavan Boxing Club. I'm going to go to the youngest here because I know you're only new here in Cavan Boxing Club. But what made you decide that you wanted to take up boxing?
Fit, get fit, be just protection.
Yeah. And who's your favourite boxer?
Manny Pacquiao.
Manny Pacquiao. Ah, I thought you were going to say John Joe Nevin. That's what you were meant to say. But we'll come to Martin. Martin, you've been on the show before. So how has your year been, or, you know, kind of going forward, what are you hoping for?
I'm just hoping for the best. Like, whatever happens, happens. But, like, training good enough. But should be good things in the future, like, anyways.
Yeah. So it's as Brian said, you need to have the hunger. And yeah. If you have that going forward.
You need the hunger, like, when you're fighting. Because tough boxers, like, but. That's what you're getting, like, no.
Yeah. So we hope to hear more from you in the future. So the two brothers here are going to come over here. Does there be many rows at home, or do you be practicing in your bedroom, or what goes on?
We practice in the shed. We train in the shed together.
Oh, very good. Okay. So who's the older?
Me.
Yeah. And so you were doing really well when you were in Kansas.
Yeah.
Tell us, how did you enjoy the competition?
Yes, very good it was. Good experience as well.
And Brian's really, he said lots of good things about you, and I think he thinks that, you know, you've got a great future ahead of you.
Yeah.
You're going to keep going. So what's the dream, guys?
I don't know.
Would you like to make it to the Olympics? Would you like going forward?
Yeah.
Like on the Irish team or going to that, yeah.
Brilliant. Hello. Right, I'm going to move over here to the girls. Not just the girls. What's this young man's name?
Eamon.
We'll come over here beside Eamon. So tell us, you're Ulster...
champion.
Oh my goodness, right. So how long have you been boxing?
Since I was 9.
And you're how old now?
12.
12, right, yep. So 3 years.
Yep.
That's not very long, is it?
Yep.
Right, so literally these guys better watch out.
Not really, because I kind of know them all, and they're all good boxers as well.
Yeah.
And so the girls.
Brilliant. So you sound like you're very determined, and you're like working hard at coming down to the club every night.
Yeah, well, not kind of every night, like some nights.
You're just, when you're doing your homework, he hasn't got time, is that it?
Yeah, kind of.
Oh, very good. We wish you the best luck. Maria, first of all, congratulations. So you're expecting, you're due in December.
Yeah.
I was actually feeling really anxious watching you in the ring when you were sparring, but, you know, no bother to you at all.
We know people here, they know I'm pregnant, they're not going to go for my body. And, you know, I train hard, I want to keep up my fitness, I want to get back into it as soon as possible. I hope that maybe I'll gain a few kilos and I can fight in the seniors. I'd love to fight in the seniors, you know, no matter what happens, I'd just love the chance to get in there and just try it. But I'm hoping to get back as soon as possible after. That's why I'm training so hard as I am now. So
you'll kind of maintain your fitness somewhere.
Yeah. I don't know what it's like to have a baby, but I'm hoping to get back into a stream.
I don't think you're going to be short on babysitters around here, so you've got lots of them. You can take it in turns.
Hopefully.
We'll look at best of luck with that, and we'll be looking forward to hearing more about you in the future. And then Kaylee, so you've been, and you just come back from Kansas as well, and you got on really well there. Brian said he was really proud of you, and, you know, you've made great improvements since you started here in the club.
It was tough competition, and I'm just glad to get the second, so yeah, and I'm really happy with that now.
Yeah. I suppose for anybody watching, and obviously from a female point of view, you know, what would you say to people out there who are kind of thinking about, particular girls, thinking about, oh gosh, I'd like to get involved in boxing, I'd like to come down to a club, what would you say to them?
Oh, join, absolutely. It's not like it's a rough sport, but it's really good for fitness and all that kind of stuff, and you gain so much confidence as well, so I really recommend it.
Which is great. Brilliant. Okay, I'm going to go back over here to the last two. Sorry, Nathan and Harrison. Okay, so we were just discussing your name. So Harrison, you box with Virginia Boxing Club, but you come here during the week then, or whenever you can, because you're in school in Cavan, is that right? Right, so you got on well as well. You were over in Kansas. Was that one of your first?
No, it was my fourth trip away.
Fourth trip away, okay. So enjoy it?
Yeah, it was brilliant.
Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah, I lost to the eventual champion in the semis, and he's very strong, and just, you know, touch and go.
Very good. Okay, and Nathan, they're very shy. They're shy when the camera's around, but they're not shy in the ring. Okay, so don't be fooled. Nathan, we had you on All About Sport before, so you shouldn't be shy. You should be a pro with this now, but you're working hard, and that's what Brian said, that you're really a hard worker. In the ring. Yes. on, Shai. If your opponents are watching, come on. But Nathan, you love this sport. And your dad's obviously, I know I've seen your dad down here with you before, and he's obviously pushed into it, but it's something that you love.
It's hard sporting.
Would you prefer to be doing this full-time or in school?
I prefer to do this.
Good. Okay, well, look, it's something that you can be working towards, and I suppose it's a future goal. Well, look at it. So, I mean, Brian, thank you so much for inviting us into Cavan Boxing Club. It's wonderful to speak to the future of the Cavan Boxing, and, you know, this, well, I suppose all credit is due to Brian McKeown, but thank you very much, and best of luck to you all going forward in all the different and various competitions. And again, many thanks to Ciara Smith. I know she's hiding over there at the side of the ring, and we're going to be really following her along the way. So that's it. So we'll all say goodbye, right? So it's goodbye from me, Louise O'Reilly, and everyone here at Cavan Boxing Club.